Good evening, everyone. So I'm Dario. I'm here for Pool of Stake. I was expecting much more engagement, but maybe you don't know what's that one. So basically, a step back on the history, on the past. So at the beginning of our experience in Bitcoin, you need to have a just PC, a computer, you need to have a program, and then you start to mine. And so basically, that was the beginning of everything. It was very easy and very basic. And then you know what? So much more powerful equipment has been developed. And then was a change of the game, because it was a little bit much more complex to mine Bitcoins. So maybe you experienced something similar. But then something else changed the game and changed everything, because the beginning of the pool was a kind of first revolution in which simple people like me, like you, re-jump back on the discussion. So even if you don't have that fancy and powerful equipment, you can restart to be in the game. And that was the origin of everything. And that was a great inspiration, because we have to remember the past to invent and imagine the future. So basically, that can look like the future. So basically, the proof of stake will become dominant or predominant in the near future. This is at least which the market is going to tell us. And basically, the market also is evolved in the favor of proof of stake. And the idea was, okay, so we are a group of people. Why we cannot create a pool for proof of stake blockchain? So something easy, something lean, something basic. And basically, in order to do something like that one, we are utilizing three pillars. The first pillar is to create a system fully trustless, because the trust is something very important. The second, we need to bring visibility to people, because the visibility is also a second important asset in our world. And last but not least, governance. So basically, if we are capable somehow to develop something similar, we will be succeed in our project. Now, how it works. So something very easy. Someone like myself, or you, you can get a token, basically a POS coin. In our example, Bob. Bob is our man. He's the man of the night. And so basically, Bob is holding a POS coin. And what's happened at the beginning? At the beginning, Bob is making a transaction into the proof of stake blockchain. And then PSK jump in the equation, because through a smart contract, you can get something back, an IOU. Basically, the IOU is the first token of the night. So the IOU is a kind of certificate. It's something that is capable to prove the ownership of something. Without that IOU, you cannot do anything. So basically, the IOU is something important. Prove the ownership of something that you have. And you know what? When you bring your POS coin into our node, we start to forge together. So you will contribute to the forging, and it will become a sort of community. And that is the first part. The idea behind, okay, is changing blockchain by blockchain, because right now, so every blockchain works slightly different from that one. Some blockchain, they distribute reward, equally distribute. So if you have one coin, 10 coin, 100 coin, you get the same reward for the proportional point of view, for the percentage point of view. Other blockchain, they're working with a critical mass. So bigger you are, much more you can get. And so basically what we are doing, every night, we are taking a snapshot on what reward we are generating together. And then we are assigning to yourself, Bob, a contribution. Proportional contribution on what you can generate for the pool. And so you have to imagine that Bob, in his wallet, every night, get new IOU. So new certificate of ownership of the reward generated. And so that is the initial step of our idea. It's very easy, it's very basic, because with that IOU, you can recall your coin and you can transform your IOU, the ownership of what you have, in your coin, in your original coin. That was the idea behind. I have one question from the stage.
I feel like I'm an idiot.
You are not. Next question.
I just said I feel like I was an idiot. Well spotted. So are you saying that if I put coins onto the chain, something it becomes more valuable, and then I automatically get more stuff afterwards, even if I haven't done anything? I've done no work, I've done no... It just magically becomes more valuable. Is that right?
You are totally right. Maybe instead of the word magically, I will utilize something different, like engage, support, blockchain. And this is the principle of
Does this work for Bitcoin?
Not Bitcoin, because it's proof of work. The proof of work, it works with the physical work of your machinery. The POS, it works with the staking. And so basically, if you are kind of staking something, you are contributing. And based on the contribution of reliability, of support of the community, you get something back. And that something back basically is the reward. You can also do yourself. You don't need to utilize us. But if you do yourself, you need to have something else, like your own PC, your own machinery, your own quantity of tokens. So it's really the concept of pool, so to join the effort to do something bigger. It was right? Delia? Thanks. And so basically, that's very easy and basic. And here, I want to introduce you the second, let me say, coin of the night. That is our coin. The pool of stake coin, it's very important on that one, and it's a kind of innovative token. So basically, at the beginning, we were thinking about something like a simple coin to pay some fees, to get kind of service. But that was too easy, so we don't like easy things. And we were thinking something much more crazy and innovative. So instead of utilize your coin, you have to hold your coin. You have to keep in your wallet. That coin in your wallet, it stays. You don't have to utilize in our platform. We don't want it. You don't have to utilize to withdraw your coin. That is free of charge. You just need to keep enough amount to cover everything. And basically, based on the amount of the token that you have during the snapshot, you can have something between 85 and 95% of your reward. And so basically, what do we have here in the middle? In the middle, we have our operative margin. So we make something like, we make the platform up and running with that intermediate part. But the mathematics is not a theory, so we are missing 5% to the 100, if I'm not mistaken. And so basically, we're utilizing this 5% in order to utilize the gas, because basically, you have to imagine a lot of several transactions on chain as a gas, just to exchange the IOU between us. And we are utilizing also the 5% to buy the PSK token with the market price and to keep in hold in order to create a kind of standard or declining amount of token on the market. Basically, that is our idea. And what you have to do to get something back at the end of the process, you can call for your IOU and you can get back some original token. And the innovative concept of that one is this flow, it's totally free of charge. So in our business model, so we get stability just utilizing the reward of the community. That was easy, lean, and basic.
Is this like how banks handle deposits from customers? Basically, give the bank your money, the bank does stuff with it, and then you go to take the money out? And
I bet that if I will ask to your bank your statement of your bank account, your bank will not share with me how much you have. But if you ask to us how much we are having in total, I can share with you how much. And so this is slightly different, right. And also beside the blockchain, we want to make something easy because one important asset, one important pillar of our project is the visibility. And we will see in one slide, what does it mean that one? How that could be converted from theory to the reality. And basically that is something that was tried to describe. So a second pillar of what we are doing is the visibility. You as a user, you don't know, you don't care that much on how much reward you are generating. You don't want to make the fancy calculation because maybe sometimes you are very busy. And then you want to have a kind of something easy. One click, simple button through our platform, and you have your several transactions under control. And the second topic is that one, maybe you want to have a benchmark. Basically, because the idea will be to not just have one POS coin, but we're going to have several of these ones. Maybe you want to benchmark yourself with all the other coins, because it's in the human nature, and it's happened to me that I'm impassioned with a project I like, I hold, I suffer with the coin, but at the end of the story, I don't know what the other they are doing, and maybe I want to get something better, and then I can change my mind. So the second platform, the second important topic on the platform is the visibility. And the idea will be to be capable or to ensure to all our members of the community to benchmark themselves with someone else. Why we can do that one? We can do that one because we have data. We have number, and because we can also, and because we can track and trace everything on the blockchain. Easy and simple. Last but not least, apps. When we're talking about money, question comes. Easy answer, yes.
So it's free that I can see all the data?
Let me say, nothing is free in the life.
Yes, I know that.
So let me say, you're not paying. So also that one, it's included in the percentage between the 85 and the 95%. Maybe I have a second question here, Andrew?
Ask later, keep going.
Great. No, you're not doing.
We interrupt all the time.
They're very challenging guys. In Swiss people, they're much more calm than you. Wow, it's a really change of attitude. I like it.
That's because we're all doing Tinder. We're paying attention.
Ooh la la. Last but not least, in one slide, I will introduce the queen of governance. She's very sensitive on that topic. I have to be careful what I'm saying. And so basically, we have also an important asset on our platform, which is governance. Basically, you have to imagine that we have two kinds of governance. Something that we call internal governance and something that we call external governance. Basically, the internal is something that any member of our community, they can vote and ask us, hey guys, please implement that fancy mechanism to that blockchain, to that project, to that coin. And basically, we do what we want. These are our philosophy. And the second is much more external governance. Basically, every blockchain has their own governance. And the idea that we have, because we are a kind of last of romance people, so we like to grow the engagement of any blockchain, supporting the governance, raising the voice, helping people to take a direction that even our community want to be. You have to imagine that the platform is not for big people, heavy investors, rich men, no Lambo in our field. So we're imagining something much more basic people. We will see in a few slides which one is our share. And basically, you have to imagine that by yourself, you cannot do anything. But if you are joining the effort also for the governance, we can raise the voice and we can also try to help any blockchain to take a direction on this one. I learned that by yourself, you cannot do anything. And that's the reason why we have a fancy team. So I'm here on the upper part of the corner with Davide and Andrea. We are the three co-founders. Here with me, we have also Delia. Delia, please stand up. A big applause to Delia. She's the queen of the governance. And we made also a strategic partnership with Navarra.is. Bartosz is here, one of the best marketing men in Berlin, maybe in Germany. I don't want to exaggerate, maybe in the world. And basically, Bartosz is helping us to cover everything regarding the marketing, regarding the engagement. Why? Because in our business plan, so we know if we are capable to explain that very technical and very critical platform in an easy way, we can engage and to have much more people. And that will be a success of our project. So basically PSK, we can combine the benefit of mining, so we're kind of mining, with the decentralization and with the blockchain. So basically we try to do all in, easy and basic. Assumptions, something very basic. So my mathematical background, it's very excited about numbers. And as you can see here, we have a really stable increase of member in our community. So if we can keep the same speed, so we can do really great numbers. As you can see, we are expecting an injection number, so kind of personal injection, very little or very reasonable, let me say. And last but not least, very important, all the crazy mechanism of withdraw and get is free of charge. So we don't need that kind of charge. Basically, we are making something in between the reward that we make for the cryptos. So those are the number. In order to do that one, surprise, we are running an ICO, woohoo. Basically, few numbers. In order to achieve our target, the best will be to reach the famous 8 million investment. In the benchmark with other ICO, we are in the middle low part of the comparison. So we are not asking big money. We are not willing to go to the moon. We want to stay very stable. Basically, Barbara correctly introduced ourselves and not just myself because we are coming from the ICO world. So we know from the ICO point of view the expectation, what people they want. And that's the reason why when we are thinking about the token distribution, we are thinking the token distribution from two angles. The first angle is for the user of the community. So how the user will utilize our token and how the token will make sense on the platform. But last but, last but not least, we are thinking also about investors and people from the ICO. That's the reason why we were jumping on that kind of perfect equation of distribution between vested token and holded token. And basically, we want to keep also some of those tokens in 2 years. And why PSK will be locked for 2 years? Because in 2 years, we'll reach our break-even point. So the point that we want to reach is in 2 years' time.
And which jurisdiction are you doing this in, and are you registering as a security?
No, thanks God we're not. So basically our token...
God doesn't care as much as you think.
Right? Basically our token is a pure service token because you're not holding any value on that one. You're really using that token to do something. And then also the fact that you are not even moving the token, just you are keeping the token, that also will bring you to a second level of easy token in order to not land in the security token.
Will the value of the token ever go up?
We don't know. We don't know if the token will go up. We don't know if the token will go down. So let me say the market will decide and we cannot interfere or influence. So liberal. And basically that is not, let me say, something that we can predict. We are just inquiring because we are a Swiss company and basically in order to be confident that our token is a pure token compliant with everything and a very utility token. So we are also supported by a Swiss lawyer that is in touch with the Swiss BaFin, so the FINMA, in order to, right, I see some exciting people here. I'm not arguing on your addiction, but okay. So you can imagine it was difficult, the discussion with them, but we did it. And so basically we are landing in a kind of safe zone.
So I was in Zurich a couple of weeks ago at the crypto conference, and they were sharing how Swiss laws have sort of changed and adapted. Mm-hmm. Do you want to share about if you're a utility token and you're in use, you get special treatment? Is this what you're doing?
I don't know. I'm not that much legal on that one, but I don't know if you have other insights.
Anybody else? What they were sharing is that you can be a utility token if you have an actual functioning product. Apparently this was like a really big deal. Yeah. The definition of what a functioning product is has not been specified. So it could actually be anything. But then it allows it to be a utility. And the most interesting thing actually from my perspective is that there is regulatory equivalence between different jurisdictions if they allow you to be regulatory equivalent. So when I did the IPO for my software company on the London Stock Exchange, that meant that my shares could be traded in New York on NYSE and others. That's regulatory equivalence. I'm not sure if FINMA has got regulatory equivalence for this yet, but if it's the beginnings of the path towards regulatory equivalence, it means we can use places like Switzerland and FINMA. But the thing is then, are we going to get away with securities laws? And it's impossible that, anyway, if it was pure security, I mean, if it wasn't traded, then it probably will be getting away with it. I think the Swiss law is going to get busted, my personal view.
Good challenge, and this is a challenge for each of us. The nice thing is that one, not just for Swiss company, but for the entire world company, landing in that one. So we see a kind of evolution on the market, and we see a kind of insecure part. For example, also, in our case, if you try to go to any tax advisor and talking about Ether and Bitcoin reward in that one, there is a not clear statement from the German authority. So it's kind of tricky and complex. And so we imagine now a kind of physiological evolution on that one. And the best that I can share with you now, it's what we got from our lawyer.
There is no equivalence between the Swiss and the EU law. There is an equivalence inside the EU.
Correct.
That's true. If you get a regulatory approval in one European country, you are automatically approved in the rest of the EU. But as soon as you do that in Switzerland, who cares? You can only sell to Swiss investors without getting into trouble.
With all the respect, the first part was not totally correct because it's not stated that if you're complying in Germany, you are complying also in Greece or in France. There is a good probability. So this is also a second tricky part because something that we call European Union maybe is not so harmonized.
A financial product that is allowed to sell in one European mm-hmm. Union country is always allowed in other countries.
No, sort of. So there's different levels of it. So the European market isn't sort of fully standardized across Europe. which means you can have, I mean, each country has its own national laws, and it doesn't mean to say that they're automatically harmonized. So there's some level that's harmonized, but a lot of it isn't.
That's a real challenge for us.
And for everybody trying to make money out of this stuff.
Absolutely.
And not lose it.
Basically,
so how many proof of stake coins will you be having on your platform?
Basically, the idea, so we have a rolling phase. And maybe you can see here the rolling phase, because we have already right now a MVP, so a minimum viable product. And right now we are working on Qtum testnet. So basically we have that kind of mechanism. So right now we have one. And the idea when we are going to release the first platform, which means 2018 Q3, we're going to have four blockchain fully integrated. Don't underestimate this one. So why? Because the four that you need to get is pretty relevant. Sorry? I cannot share something. I cannot share with you that information because we are kind of below secrets, that one. Someone will kill myself who will do it. But for the moment, we are counting for four chains. And so...
Which one will be the... Which one will be still left in 4 years?
Hey, they're still also recording myself, so I have to be careful. That is a good question.
That's a great question.
It's not a secret that maybe also Ethereum is moving in one specific direction. So we have a name on the table, which is Casper. So Mr. Vitalik is trying also to figure out how move from one part to the second one, Ethereum. And it's not a secret that Ethereum is very attractive for a product like this one. And basically, as you can see, two maybe milestone, and then I have to stop because I see big sign from Barbara in front of the front stage. So we're gonna start, just joking, Barbara, you can do everything you want. So basically we want to go on the market. So we want to go on the market May the 2nd, please join us. And then we want to release also two platforms because our roadmap is it's pretty tight, but we have already good material. And basically, I'm kindly invite you also to follow us, very important. We have a huge community. We have also a great Telegram channel. So we want to share everything from you, from us to you. And basically, we want also try to engage people. And then what I can say, thanks to everyone.